Good morning and welcome to Hashtag
Rise in Bond.
I am your host, Glenn Lundy. I am a husband to one, a father to six, and the general manager of Dan Cummins, a Chevrolet Buick in Paris, Kentucky, the second largest used car franchise dealer in the United States of America. It is 5:30 a.m., and I hope that you are ready to rise and grind.
Yo, 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 what's up, everybody? Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. It is Tuesday, June 5th, 2018. And, bro, ladies and gentlemen, I was thinking this morning, man, first of all, I'm so excited for this episode. This episode that we are about to have right here is going to be straight fire. I'm just letting you know that right now. But listen, I wasn't supposed to be here, right? I was not supposed to be here. See, my life was not supposed to work out like this. It wasn't supposed to work out like this. Okay? And so we're gonna dig in a little bit today, and I'm gonna talk to you about how you, or a guy like me, you know, how we can make it through to, like, the other side, okay? Through the darkness, through all the failures, through the unknowns, and into the light. But first, I want you to understand, this isn't going to be a story about how I got through my struggles. Instead, we're going to share where we're at today, the mindset today, and some of the stuff that I do on a daily basis, some of the things that I do on a daily basis to be able to maintain and continue to push through that. I think it's going to be incredibly valuable for you guys. I really do. But of course, before we do all of that, you guys know what we got to do, right? Does everybody know what we got to do? I wonder if I can, let's see if we can, let's go with this today. How you guys feel about this today? Let's see. Come on. How about that? Part of the show. If you don't know, it's the best time to hit that share button and get everybody up in here for the hashtag rise and grind. While we're all sitting here chair dancing, and we're all sitting here getting our energy up, and we're all sitting here getting hype and ready for the day, it's the best time to say good morning. Good morning to my big and awesome, amazing new friend Ben Workman. And good morning to Miss Fanny Campbell. Good morning to Eddie Gilbert, John Weatherby, Sheila, Jessica Terrell, what's up, Josh? Oh! Good morning, Jared Mosley. Good morning, Melvin. Good morning, John. Everybody say good morning to everybody else. Good morning, Archie. Good morning. What's up, my man, Eric Jones? I'm in here, I love it. Today we got a bad to the bone episode. Today we got the eye of the tiger frozen. Good morning, Rick Berman and AJ Jones and Patrick Booth. What's up? It's that good buddy. Before we even start, look, hit the share button. You need to do that. In case you don't know, we're having an event on August 12th. Hashtag Rise and Grind. It's going to be hype. It's speaking and music. You need to be a part of that. Go to GlennLundy.com. Get your tickets. My wife's got a flag to go on the ride right here. Go to GlennLundy.com. You got to check it out. I just want to throw all that in there before we dive. Unrecognizable. We've been talking about unrecognizable. Everybody's on this 30-day challenge. I asked you guys yesterday how you were doing. Everybody said they're doing really well with unrecognizable. They've decided that we're gonna change something in our life, one major thing in our life that's going to make us unrecognizable 30 days from now from the person that we were at the beginning of June. Completely different person at the end than we are at the beginning. Completely unrecognizable. And check it out. It's been amazing, dude. I don't know if you guys paid as much attention as I have. But it's incredible, the life-changing stuff that's happening in this group. It's incredible. But check it out. All right, I'm a black guy, right? I'm a black guy from the West Coast with a troubled past and a criminal record. All right, I have a past addiction. I have two kids out of wedlock.
All right. I came from a lower middle class upbringing. I had a homeless stint in my life. I have a failed suicide attempt, and I was a non-believer. Okay. Black guy, West Coast, troubled past, criminal record, past addiction, two kids out of wedlock, lower middle class upbringing, homeless stint, failed suicide attempt, and I was a non-believer. Okay? I wasn't supposed to be here. I wasn't supposed to be here. Because yet, even though all of those things were who I was, today, I run a dealership, a massive dealership, Dan Cummins Chevrolet and Buick, second largest dealership in the country, okay? I run a massive dealership in a tiny town in Kentucky, which being brown, I never would have thought I would have landed in a tiny little town in Kentucky of 9,600 people, just saying. I own a beautiful home in a beautiful neighborhood. I have an amazing wife. I have 7 kids, okay? I host an incredible show at 5:30 in the morning, 5 days a week, with over 27,000 members in the group. Dude, in October 8th and 9th, I will be on stage speaking with Eric Thomas, the Eric Thomas. I currently live a life of abundance. And dude, me and God, the God, the big G, dude, we're homies, man. Me and God are homies. I talk to my boy every day. All right, so at 30 years old, I was set to fail and destined to go downhill. I was set to fail and destined to go downhill. At 35 years old, I was set to succeed on a level I could have never imagined. And at 40 years old, now I'm set to absolutely explode. Right? But I wasn't supposed to be here. I wasn't supposed to be here. I was the black guy from the West Coast with the troubled past and the criminal record and the past addiction, who had 2 kids out of wedlock, who came from a lower middle class upbringing, who had a homeless stint, a failed suicide attempt, and I was a non-believer in God. But yet here I am today. So I thought, okay, listen, I've told my story a ton of times. A lot of you guys have heard it. If you haven't heard the whole story, go back. I got over 100+ videos on my website or on glennlundy.com. You can go to glennlundy.com. There's over 100 videos there, right? So I've got all that. If you want to go back and dive into my past and my trials and my tribulations and how I got here, because it's all there, and sometimes that's really, really important. But that's not what it's about today. Today, what I want to talk to you about, I want to talk to you about the mindset today. I want to talk to you about how I maintain today. I want to talk to you about what goes through my head every single day now that I'm in the position that I'm in, now that I'm where I'm at, because I feel like that can help all of us. I feel like as we go through these unrecognizable challenges, I feel like as we go through these 30 days where we have these struggles, where we're trying to break through, where we have some wins and we have some losses, I feel like now is the time where you're like, bro, you got me here. You got me here. But now that I'm here, how do I stay here? How do I not fall back? How do I not let the pressures and the intensity, how do I not let that beat me down, right? Right? So check it out. I'm going to give you 6 things today. If my boy Mike Brockway, I believe Mike's in here. If Mike's in here, he'll keep notes. All right, I got 6 things. For those of you that are just joining in, like my boy Zach Toomey, good morning, Zach. I am so glad you're here. William Sherman, good morning. I am so glad you're here. Heather Hyatt, good morning. I am so glad you're here. You guys continue to hit that share button. This is about to be an amazing show. I'm about to drop 6 things on you, okay? Because I was not supposed to be in the position I am today. And now that I'm in it, I'm gonna share with you 6 things that I do, 6 things that you can do, that when you start to reach higher levels of success, when you start to break out, break away from being who you were and becoming this new person that's unrecognizable, you can use these 6 things. Number 1, I remind myself every single day that professional athletes lose their starting positions every single day, and not just some of them, all of them. All of them. You hear me? Emmitt Smith, Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, Jerry Rice, Randy Johnson, Alex Smith, John Elway, every single one of them lost their starting position at some point. Every single one of them had to hang up the cleats, man. Every single one. I remind myself every day that a professional, as a professional, myself, there's somebody out there. There's somebody out there one day that is going to take my seat. Someday somebody's going to come in and take it from me. I understand that. And so every single day I fight for my position. Every single day, it's like it's my first day on the job. Every single day I fight. I battle for my position. Every day. And you need to do the same thing. Every single day you should fight for your position. Every single day you should be lacing up your cleats, preparing to go into battle. Every day you need to remind yourself that there's someone out there that's trying to outwork you, someone out there that's trying to outtrain you, someone out there that's going to be younger than you, that's going to be faster than you, that's gonna come up behind you. And if you're not paying attention and you're not working diligently to maintain your position, to exceed your value, to exceed your paycheck. If you're not doing that every single day, then someone's going to come in and take your job sooner than you might think. They're going to come in and take your spot sooner than you expected. So me personally, I remind myself every day, even the best of the best, even these athletes that we all know their name, even these ones that go down in history as the greatest of all time, even them, One day, somebody came in and took their starting position. So when's that day going to be? For me, that day is going to be a long ways away, I can tell you that. Because if you're going to take my spot, you better bring it, bro. You better bring it. I'm just telling you right now, you better figure out how to sleep 4 hours a night. You better have to figure out how to sleep 4 hours a night, how to add in way, way, way more value than your paycheck ever is. I'm going to tell you that right now. If you're going to come after my spot, because I'm fighting for it every single day. I remember the streets. I remember what it's like to be homeless. I remember what it's like to sleep on buses, and I'm not going back, period. You feel me? That's the attitude I need you to have. It's the attitude you need to have going into your place of employment every single day. You need to fight for your job. So number one, that's the one thing. Remind yourself every day that even a professional athlete loses their starting position. Number two, I only count my wins, man. I only count my wins. My losses are forgotten, plain and simple. Simple. If I talk to five people, say I talk to five customers at work, right? If I have to go in, I talk to five customers, I try to close five deals, and four of them leave, and I close one, guess what story you're going to hear? Guess what story my boss is going to hear? Guess what story all my coworkers are going to hear? They're going to hear about the one I closed, because I only count my wins. I don't count my losses. For example, Dan Cummins Chevrolet and Buick. Last month, our goal, we didn't hit it. But guess what we focused on? Guess what? We did break a record. We had a record May. We came short of the goal, but that's not what we talked about. We talked about the fact that we had a record May. I only count my wins. I don't count my losses. I just don't. Like when I'm playing ball with the boys, I'll go play basketball with the boys on Tuesdays. When we get to work, we're going to talk about all the shots Glenn Lundy made. We're not talking about all the shots Glenn Lundy missed. It's just not going to happen. Listen, if you only count your wins here, write this down. Write this down. If you only count your wins, then winning is all that counts. You like that? You like that? If you only count your wins, then winning is the only thing that counts. Strong, right? That's strong, bro. I'm telling you. If that's the only nugget you get out of this thing, you got to roll. Look, quit counting your losses, folks. The losses don't matter. We're all going to lose. We're all going to fail. We're all going to struggle. We're all going to fall down. It's going to happen all the time. It's all the time. But you can't focus on that, man, because if you focus on your losses, guess what begins to matter? Guess what begins to add up? Your freaking losses. The losses are become the reality. Forget that, man. The wins. It's all about the wins. Okay? If you only count your wins, then winning is all that counts. I hope my boy Sean Hayes pops up in here because he's going to love that one. All right, number three. All right? I share, and again, write this down, and if you got a pen, write it down. If you don't, go back and watch it again. And if you haven't hit share yet, hit that share button. I'm telling you, If your friends only watch one episode of Hashtag Rise and Grind, it needs to be this one. Okay? Check it out. Number three. I share ideas with my coworkers. I share goals with my friends and family members. I share visions with God. Okay? Ideas with coworkers, goals with friends and family members, visions with God. Let me break this down, okay? Coworkers can help me create. They're not as attached, and they can tell me if I have a bad idea, right? Okay, hey, I got this idea, man. We should probably do this for the company. It's going to be great. Oh, yeah, Glenn, that's a great idea. I can help. Awesome. Great. I need help. Or they can be like, bro, that's a terrible idea because they don't really care about my feelings as much as I would like them to, and so they just kind of tell me the truth, right? Awesome. Good. So that's why I share my ideas with them. Now, goals, I don't necessarily want to share goals with coworkers. I want to share goals with people that care about me a little bit more, that are maybe going to encourage me and that are going to lift me up, kind of like unrecognizable, right? The unrecognizable program, we share that with each other so we can encourage and lift each other up. Now, our big visions, your big, big, big dreams, your big, big, big visions, we don't want to share those with anybody but God, man. Those are for you and God until they start to become an actual goal, okay? Because your friends, your family members, and your coworkers will shoot down your visions. They will shoot down these amazing big visions of grandeur that God gave you. They'll shoot them down, okay? So visions we keep with God, right? Our goals we share with our friends and family members, and our ideas, those are for coworkers. Does that make sense? And that's something I live with. That's something I live by every single day, okay? Pretty neat, right? All right, check it out. Plus, you know, God can make things happen. So you want to share your visions with him. All right, check it out. Number four. And I'm scooting up just a little bit because I'm seeing where I'm at on time. Okay. I dedicate 3 hours. Number four. I dedicate 3 hours a day to being the best me that I can possibly be. 3 hours a day. Now, that's me. Now, you might not be able to get in 3 hours, but here's the important part. You have to dedicate a section of time every single day. Every single day, you must dedicate time to being the best version of you that you can possibly be. You have to do this, people. I know, especially the women in this group. I know so many women in this group that will spend their entire lives serving others, and they won't freaking take an hour to take care of themselves, man. Dude, I know people have told you not, don't be selfish and blah, 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 blah. You have got to be selfish. You have to fill your own cup in order to be able to go out there and succeed and maintain high levels of success. Okay, there's a video, 5 things you have to do every single day that will change your life. Apply that video to your life. Do those 5 things, please. I'm begging you. I'm begging you to be selfish this morning. I'm begging you to become the best version of you that you can be this morning. I'm begging you to focus on becoming a better you. It's so hard, man. It is one of the hardest things, especially when you have a big heart and you care about people and you're kind. It is so hard to be selfish. But on Tuesday, June 5th, 2018, you heard it from Glenn. You have my permission. Not only my permission, it's required. If you want to maintain, if you want to stay at a higher level, you have to find time to take care of yourself. All right? Where are we at? All right. All right, so we talked about the athlete reminder, right? We remind ourselves every day that a professional athlete loses his position. We only count our wins, right? Because when we only count our wins are the only thing that counts, right? All right, we share our ideas with coworkers, our goals with friends, our visions with God. We're going to take care of ourselves. We got 2 more things that we got to pop in real quick, okay? I diligently exclude all negativity from my life. And when I say I diligently exclude it, I mean in all forms from all people. I don't allow it around me, period, done, zip, zero, nada. If you're negative, get the heck out. I can't deal with you. I can't mess with you. God loves you, but I might even love you, but I'm out. We can't hang out. We can't have fun. You can't be around me. We can't have a conversation. You can't come to my house. You can't hang out with my kids. You can't be around my grandma. You can't be around my dog. You're not allowed in my circle. The negativity's got to go. I'm not watching the news. I'm not listening to your gossip. I'm out. I got too many other things to focus on. You feel me? I think that one's clear as day. Number 6. Number 6. I realize that it's all in his hands, man. I give it all up to God every single day, dude. He gives, he allows, he protects, he loves, he forgets, he designs. And though I am the big bad lion, bro, because I'm no sheep, right? I'm a big bad lion, right? And though I am the big bad lion, I understand that God is the air that I breathe. You take away the air, and down goes the lion, brother. If you take away the air, down goes the lion. You feel me? It don't matter how big and bad you are. It don't matter how your roar, how loud your roar is. It doesn't matter if you're king of the jungle. You take away the air, and the lion goes down, bro. And God is the air that we breathe. He is the life that we live. True that. All right, cool. Y'all got those six? Did I not tell you today's show was going to be fire? Did I not tell you I was going to give you some words of wisdom that you can apply that will change your life? Did I not tell you in that little title I said, if you only watch one episode of Hashtag Rise and Grind in your entire life, I hope it's this one. Because those six things, I can tell you about my struggles. I can tell you how I got here. And I've done that in multiple videos. And if that's where you're at in your life and that's what you need, then I need you to go to glennlundy.com and go watch those videos. Okay, go watch those videos. I've shared all those stories, dude, of how I got through all that stuff. And if that's where you're at in your life, cool. But now I want to talk about where you're at today and how you maintain it and how you don't fall back. Because there's nothing worse than finally getting there and then falling back. That's the worst. So do these six things, man. Go back and watch this video again. If you need more videos, go to glennlundy.com. If you need your gear, go to glennlundy.com. Dude, my wife's got a flash sale on tanks right now. I think there's 9 tanks left. Get in there and get your, they're like $15, dude. What are you waiting for? All right? And then we have the event, August 12th, hashtag Rise and Grind. We've got 7 powerful speakers. We've got music. You need to plan on getting to this event. Do you understand? You need to plan on getting to this event. All right? It's August 12th. It's going to change your life, all right? Keep working on the hashtag unrecognizable, guys. It's changing my life. It's changing other people's lives. My arms hurt like crazy, dude, because, like, I'm telling you, man, these 2-a-day, I'm doing 2-a-days, and it's killing me, and I'm getting rocked out, and I love it, though. But check that. Look at that. Boy, that's what I'm talking about. Not bad for 40 years old. You know what I'm saying? So you guys are motivating me. Keep motivating each other. Keep sharing. Keep inviting people to the group. And just know that you're incredibly amazing human beings, man. Jeff, Josh, Vicky, Sheila, Ray, Beth, Mike, all you guys, man. These amazing human beings that were uniquely made. Uniquely made by the creator of the universe, man. God himself, to be the absolute best version of you that you can possibly be. And you guys are posting. And you guys are sharing. And you guys are making an impact on your coworkers, on your friends, on your family members. Dude, you guys are freaking killing it. And I, for one, absolutely love you for it. I absolutely love you for it. You guys are a part of this elite group of people that are choosing every single day to hashtag rise and grind. And I hope tomorrow you'll come back and join me again at 5:30 a.m. as we continue to make waves and make impact on this planet with the hashtag Rise and Grind. Have a spectacular day. Have a phenomenal day. Have an amazing, over-the-top, incredible day. Oh my gosh, I just can't believe that it's freaking June 5th, 2018, and I am alive and sharing it with you guys, man. Have an awesome day. See ya.